The radio station with more. You're listening to the radio station.
You're listening to.
This is
Radio Biafra.
Radio Biafra.
White.
The radio station with more. You're listening to the radio station.
You're listening to.
This is
Radio Biafra.
Radio Biafra.
From the land where the sun rises, lived a people as old as Mother Nature. They were happily living, prosperous, hard working, contented.
Don't let anybody understand your loyalty. I will prepare your favorites. I will do work for you when you come back.
I promise you, before you dismiss, I'll come and pick up my bicycle.
And overall, they loved each other. They are the children of the Almighty God. Ruled by men with dark hearts, ripped of all they had, including their right to freedom and a life. They were attacked with no means of self-defense, starved to death without an offense. Even children were not excluded. They were told war, but it was a genocide. Legacy is the mirror through which the truth we see. They never feared their fears. They faced their fears. Freedom is what they believed. And they died for what they believed. That we may leave this jungle, that we may leave this God-forsaken contraption, that we may live in freedom again, to ensure that they are not forgotten. A generation exists filled with the reincarnated spirit of the freedom fighters. Because without them, they are incomplete. I am Biafra. As old as Mother Nature, as old as mankind. Though intimidations and strength from the barrels of God have wounded me, but even if it's one hurt, breathing, possessed by my spirit, soon, just very soon, my children all over the universe will smile in freedom as the children of the rising sun. They will smile in happiness again. They will smile in freedom again.
My fallen heroes, for the fact that you did not give up fighting for our freedom, we will not give up.
Biafra, we're in shock. Your memories linger to the end of time.
My fallen heroes, your name will be written in gold when Biafra comes.
You all are the reasons we have come this far. And we will never stop until Biafra comes.
Go well, my fallen heroes,
as you cannot stop the sun from rising, in the same way, you can't stop Biafra, the land of the rising sun. Honor the dead.
Honor their sacrifice.
For freedom.
They pay the ultimate price.
You would ensure the whole world hears about your grievances.
Your death shall never be in vain.
Because you lay down your life for us, we will ensure that Biafra comes.
Again, fellow Biafrans, lovers of freedom, men and women of goodwill, conscious people wherever you are all over the world, I say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and to some of you good night, depending on your time zone. This is Radio Biafra Extra, and we are streaming live through Radio Biafra London. Radio Biafra London is being anchored by the deputy leader of the indigenous people of Biafra. His name is Mazi Uchi Okafor-Mefo. He is from Abatete. Abatete is in Anambra State, and Anambra State is Biafra land. Mazi Uchi Okafor-Mefo is the man who has simply assured us that he will not allow the heart of this project to see corruption. He is standing in a deputizing capacity on behalf of our Supreme Leader, Mazi Nnamdi Okukano. He is the king of Afaribeku. Afaribeku is in Omuahia. Omuahia is in Abia State. And Abia State is Biafra land. And by the grace of Chukwu Kikabiama, I am George Onyibe. I come from Abo. Abo is in Delta State. And Delta State is Biafra land. And this morning, as always, I must acknowledge the Creator. For without him, we are gone as a people. And considering the mood, the period that we are in, we couldn't be more grateful to him that we are alive today. Not because we have gotten what we seek for, not because we live in the comfort of our homes, not because the enemies are not all around our place. It is not because that there are no people with interior motive on how to kill us. But because in the end of everything they have done,
we are still here. Ibuchukwu boge madwe. Ibuchukwu boge madwe. Anya nelowa. Ibuchukwu obinigwe. Ibuchime. Ibuchukwu boge madwe. Anye na jage mahu. Nihina emaramae. Ihunanya ine na gị obioma gị o juru anyanya chimo ingwe gị mgbanwe o dị onye dị ka gị ebu afa n'omega anyị niile na-asị na n'ịdị mma o isi isi. And of course, this morning, like every other morning, our topic is simply titled The Purpose of 30th of May. And of course, this is the 27th day of the month of May, the year of Chukwuka Kabiama 2020, at exactly 5:14 a.m. Biafran time. And I think it is important we understand what 30th of May is all about. It's important. Considering that it was their action that defines who we are today, it is important, therefore, that we understand all about their actions and how it influences our driven purpose in life as Biafrans this day. 30th of May is here. Our fasting and praying will be starting from this morning. 3 days from now will be the climax of this very program. It will always stand for all eternity, even when Biafra is restored. Because there are men and women who has gone ahead of us. They were not stupid. They were not greedy. They were not out to conquer somebody. They were not there to take that which belongs to them. They went when they should have run away. When they knew that they were actually going to die, they rather live as dead men than to live a compromised society. They understand that you can choose to pretend as if all is well, but you will soon understand that all is not well. And so for this single reason, the dear life itself, for this single reason, the Bible says they fear not their life even unto death. And today we remember them. These are men, these are women who stood on the path of truth, justice, equity, transparency, fairness. Everything they believed in their heart of heart, they were pure. I can tell you that anybody who died because of Biafra, they were pure. Because most of them knew that they die. And yet they died. And others followed in turn. Today, wherever they are listening to us from, we want them to understand that we recognize their sacrifices. The role they play cannot be forgotten. For their names and actions will last in the lips of thousands of generations to come, even beyond the pyramids of Egypt. Because we were here before they came, and we will still be here after we are gone. They will talk of us, and we will always be around to bear testament to this truth. And each time we come here talking about Biafra, and each time I listen to our people from their own narratives, of course, everybody is entitled to their opinion. But there are some truths that cannot be overemphasized. I do not believe in everything I see. Neither do I put faith in all that is around me. But I believe one thing, that I'm here today, and this is my life. And I believe that this is my life. I have the right to decide how it's going to be. And I know that the best I can have to offer, it is love that comes from sincerity. Love that comes from the bottom of my heart. And any decision I choose to take today, I either live with the regret or I live with the satisfaction that I have done the right thing. But I tell you, above all, I want to live without a single regret in my heart regarding everything that I have done. And so on daily basis, we are humbled. We know we are not perfect, but yet we strive to be perfect. This is who I am. And then there was a nation. And there is a nation which was, shall be, and is to come. And that is Biafra. The whole world listening to what we say here. We were here before our land was invaded. They witnessed millions of our people murdered. They would not say anything till tomorrow morning. Because most of them who would have done the right thing are part of the problem. They kept quiet. Day in, day out, we are being slaughtered. Whether IPOB in 1929, whether IPOB in 1947, whether IPOB in 1967, whether IPOB even in 1960, whether IPOB in 1970. And then you see, we cannot be the problem, but we are the solution. Am I saying we are the solution because we are the best of best in everything we do? No. Our mission is simple. Give us Biafra. And so this morning, I want you to understand the reason why we are remembering these heroes and heroines is because they all wanted a free and fair society where all men and women are treated equally with love. That is what they fought for. And that is what we remember them for. Our mothers in 1929 saw the inhuman treatment being meted against us as a people. They were hit to the street to protest and registered their displeasure. They target riots. About 27 of them were shot dead, or is it 47? We may not know their name today. But their action is what defines who we are today. They want a society that is free and fair. I can only borrow the words of Martin Luther King. That his dream was simple. That a day will come in America where people will not be judged by the colors of their skin, but by the content of their character. Yes, he fought. Truly, he died. But I tell you, America has not gotten to that stage. They still judge you by the content of your character. If they ever said no, they lie. But I do not stand to condemn them, but I condemn the war that lives in the shadow of evil and yet parade with the garment of righteousness. They understand the need why you must live and allow me to live. And so everything Louis Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu fought for, his son risked the comfort his father has made for him. And for 3 years, he fought for the right of the indigenous people. And I believe that the heart of these people were pure. They were not willing to sacrifice anybody to meet up with their own demand. They were willing to die. If it be death, I die. And those of you who walk on the same path, make sure you represent them for who they are. For the fear of danger they saw ahead of their people, they were willing to die to make sure that that doomsday never come upon us. They could have run away. They could have looked for a better way. They saw doomsday coming. But then they felt they could stop it. They stood their ground. Against all odds, fighting for a people who will not understand you, who will be easily ready to judge you and misinterpret your actions. It is normal. We welcome it. Yet they stood. If everybody was given the privilege to speak today, most of you will condemn Dim Chukwuemeke or Dimegu Ojukwu. But let me tell you one truth. They also condemned Jesus, even though the Bible said he died for your sin. Yet they condemn him. He is dying for his sin. That is why God has abandoned thee. But then, understand, their action is what defines us this day. They fear what we will be going through today. As we fear what will happen to the next generation if we fail to do what we are supposed to do. And then we are here. And so when you are in the moment of this remembrance period, do not think it is for enjoyment. Do not think it's for the faint of heart. Do not think it's a moment of trying to put up program. But in a sober reflection, understand, try to feel their pain. They didn't choose it. It was brought upon them. And I still tell you this morning, do not forget that it is their action and sacrifice that has led us here. And in their will to survive, our character is defined. And number three, for the fear of the danger, they saw ahead of the people. Rather, remembering them does not only keep hope alive, but encourage those who are living to continue from where they stop. Like I said, remembering them, those who died, was not just a way to keep hope alive, but actually a source of encouragement to keep us moving. May I tell you that if people like General Philip Effiong refuse to take bribe in order to betray Biafra or talk down to Biafra, are you telling me that is not enough reason for me to stand shoulder by shoulder with him? Are you telling me that if there are people like Okoko Dem who will stand on the mic of Radio Biafra in their own time, giving hope to the Biafran soldier more than bread and water would have done, are you telling me I should be discouraged while I have the privilege of being here? I can only draw strength from their action. This is what defines us. We do not just remember them for the sacrifice they have made, but for the courage they have shown, which powers our will to do what we are doing today, knowing fully well that the same people who led us out may abandon us, we stand here. Knowing fully well that at the end of the day, we may be misunderstood. We stand here because these men did not back down even when all the world was let loose against them. Their action this day defines who we are. May I remind you that one of the fourth things you need to focus on, Remembrance Day opens the door for us to reevaluate our state in the current circumstances in order for us to reaffirm our belief on their sacrifice. Today, as we go into prayers, remembering their sacrifice, like other people who have gone before them, I want you to feel their pain. I do not know what the heart of man is made of, but I know there are men that have soul and others don't. And I know that there are men and women with will and a lot more don't have. You will not understand our pain because you have not been there. I remember during the Jewish Holocaust that another man and brethren will take another homo sapien and lock them in a gas chamber and watch them die painfully, sorrowfully, until they are gone. I remember that we have encountered worse than what happened in that Jewish Holocaust. I remember that my brother Yoruba and my brother Hausa and my brother Fulani, my fellow one Nigeria, watch a crowd of over 3.5 million children within the ages of 3 and a day old starved to death. For 3 years they watched them in anguishing pain. For 3 years they swept it under the carpet. For 3 years they turned the media against them. I remember that this single act of sacrifice is what defines us today. And if that is not what you represent, it shouldn't be part of this day. We remember them on this very fateful day, telling about their story. It's all about telling about your own story, as this will enable you to experience what they have experienced. Tell somebody the story of a comrade who you have not met. And even if you will meet them, it may not be on this same dispensation. Tell them that somebody fought and died when they should have run. Tell them there are men and women who actually would have run, but they didn't have the will, the privilege, and so they died. Tell them that men and women are laying down their resources just to give us back our life that was first of all given to us freely. Tell them that the enemy has rounded us up. They make us fight against ourselves diabolically and otherwise. Tell them that we know our leaders can be misguided and we will be hunted down like animal. Tell them there are people who have been on that path before. You tell them that we are not fighting to conquer anybody. Neither did they do the same thing. Tell them we remember them. That is why we do what we do here today. That even though we are not here tomorrow, our action might define the next generation. You tell them that what we seek for is simple. What we represent is simple. We are just continuing from where they stop. They want Biafra. And we are here to ensure that Biafra is restored. They want us to live in a free and fair society. Tell them that is what we represent. They want a home they can call their home outside their home. Moses was the prince of Egypt. The Bible says, for the glory that rise ahead of him, for the nation he know nothing about, he despised the wealth of Egypt. He ran into a desert and lived like a fugitive. People who could not stand before his presence become his Lord and Master. But in all this, he harbored one dream in his heart. And that dream is that he was looking for a city which builder and maker is God. And today, we stand in the same position. How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? And I want you to go ahead this morning. Tell that Biafran soldier around you that everything is going to be all right. Because Biafra must be restored. I just need you to reflect on what they have done. And I want you to reevaluate yourself from the position where you are now. And then tell me that it's about one man. Or rather tell me that we are wrong in what we are doing. And then maybe you should tell me we do not have to fight. We just have to be slaves. We just have to let them do anything with us. But then I will ask you, can we do the same to them and then go away freely? The freedom we'll seek for will elude you. You cannot understand it until you understand why they did what they did, what they went through in their own time. And this morning, like I said, I simply say, tell the Biafran soldier that it's going to be all right.
This song is dedicated to the victims of this genocide. Those who lost their lives from 1967 to this very moment.
I had to do this song with Wewu. My brother man, I don't believe you. Shake a man, kuru beat you. My brother man, listen up. Tell that Biafran soldier that he's gonna be alright. I need to tell that Biafran soldier that it's gonna be alright. Follow me, tell
the money do we keep rising up? See betrayers wanna bring us down. The money do we keep rising up? Bring your gun and your bullet and bazooka and your grenade and Bear France. We will fight till the end. See them sabotage, playing cowardice in the corona. But we will win them all.
At this moment, our lines are open. I want you to call in and remember them. Our lines are open, just a simple request. When you call in, I pray every caller this morning will be those who are following me. I want you to remember them. I won't talk about Fulani herdsmen in our backyard. I won't talk about the deliberate emasculation of the Nigerian state against the Biafran people. I will not talk about the seed of discord that have been sown among us. I will not talk about their current atrocity ongoing as we speak about us. Because it is all these things that led the formation that made us to come to this day like this, 30th of May. Very close from now, less than 72 hours, we will light a candle for them. We will sit at home because of them. In less than 72 hours, we will make them understand that their deed still lives in our heart. We will make them understand that the height and level of conspiracy against them is unimaginable. When I sit back and I begin to wonder, why did they wipe out the map of Biafra? From Biafra, what map of the world? Why did they have to do that? I begin to wonder, what are they trying to hide from us? And now we can see through your eyes, oh heroes and heroines, dead or alive, that there is more beneath that the eyes can see. For indeed, we are greater than what we thought we are. But that's not about the greatness that undo others, but the greatness that will take the world to another level of love, horizontal, they are not yet ready to dream of. And we will show ourselves. Tell them that their death and sacrifice can never be in vain. Tell them we'll stand on the same path with them. Like our leader has referenced in one of the videos, the Spartans and the 300 men. King Leonardo and his men knew they will die. They knew they will not come back. They knew that fighting the warriors, the armies of Xerxes, a man who ruled the world, they knew they do not stand the chance to live. But they also understand that if they must die, number one, they will show the God King that he can bleed. And they made it possible. And at the end, when they were willing to die, on that very night, King Leonardo sent his most trusted bodyguard home and say, you know, we are not going to come back. Tonight we die. Tonight we'll die in victory. But somebody has to tell our story. You go back home. We have not asked for gold nor silver. Never did we say anybody should build any monument to us in honor. Tell them to remember us. Tell them to remember us. That 300 of us, the best that Spartans have, they died. They died as free men rather than live in chain. As you call me, you tell the world that our fathers and brothers and sisters and mothers and uncles and aunties and friends and enemy alike who fought, who died in order for us to be alive here, did not ask for anything. Not for a monument to be built for them, not for the praise of man, but that they may be remembered. And so today we remember them. Caller on WhatsApp, are you there?
Good morning, Mazonibe.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
My name is Simon. I am calling from my very Spain. Ichuku Okike, I am blessed every one of you. Especially today is a day we mourn those that pay the ultimate price for we to live. My dad, his friend, his brothers, those that were massacred at Gunjaga. Every one of you out there, both the children that were starved to death, the hidden name in most part of the Europe, Washoko children, and our Jim, late Jim, some people blame him. And some people say he was too radical. Some people blame him because he used his father's word to fight for Biafra. And the last president, General Philip F. Young. Anyway, they are today. They would be proud that something like me and you do exist. May their soul rest in peace. It is because of them that we are here. And I want to use this opportunity also to remember Bruce Marrock, the 20 years old Jewish American guy that first started what they call self-immolation. That is what the Tibet freedom fighters call it. They burn themselves. May his soul rest in peace today. Before I'll be laid to rest, I must go and find his burying ground and lay flower for him. So today, like as he said, Mazonibe is a sober, reflecting day. We remember them. That is why we are doing what we are doing. We did not ask them anything. We did not beg them anything. We just want to be left alone. When I have issue with people think that they can break us someday, sometime, they ask me, why are you doing this? Why? I ask them that I'm doing it for the dead because I owe my allegiance to the dead. May Chukwu Okike Adama bless every one of you. Biafra will be restored. Like the order our leader gave to read the psalm from 1 to 50. I don't know if you have it in plan.
Of course, it's everywhere.
Your program this morning, I don't know.
Everywhere on the social media. And of course, those who are to handle that will do what they are supposed to do. Thank you very much.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity. All hail Biafra.
Almost hail Biafra. Our people must remain focused. I understand some of our brain is not stable, but we must focus. Union saw Job. You say, please, don't use Greek ideology to inspire as those who worship Yahweh. You are wrong. You are wrong. I just told you the action of men, 301 men, stand against the army of the whole world. I didn't tell you about their God. And I tell you, if our actions as Biafran this day does not give us our desired end, the next generation of your people will tell you that Chukwu Okike Abiama is idol. As they have told you before now, you focus on the action of men and how they liberate their country. And then no Biafran man will be running like a woman or a coward into his home. Don't you get where we are coming from? Religion destroyed Africa. Common sense we don't have again. I'm telling you that 300 men, if they lie, let them be devil. 300 devil, put 1 million thousands of demons to fight. I am telling you to rise up like one of them. If I pay attention to you, you will make mistake. When they are telling you, follow this direction, you are showing that you have sense. Did any god, deity, come to fight for the Spartan? Did any deity die for the Spartan? Men stood and fought. I want you to learn from them. Today, those some people who stood against every doggedness and fought for their freedom, you are hiding in their country and they are giving you Bible and telling you to be holy and be patient. But in their own time, hour of fighting, in a time like this, they didn't wait for Angel Michael to help them. Men fought. Why can we become so lazy to be defending God? Are you a fool, Annie? Only Muslims defend their God. Our God defend himself. Like I said, when you call in, tell me what they have done. I want to know. And then better still, you can send a message across to them. Make them understand that their sacrifice will never be in vain. Everything they represent, everything they represent, everything they stand for, we will hold it dear. We will remember them. We will talk about them. I have understand in my experience in this journey that each time we talk about Biafra, it makes some people angry. It makes some people feel bad. It makes irritate some people. And each time I come across such people, I know they are evil. Nigerian will never tell you they are sorry that they killed 10 million of your uncle, your niece, your cousins. But then they want you to believe that it's supposed to be so. Maybe it is the art of God. Maybe it is the art of God. We have grown past the stage of sentiment. We have grown past the stage of man pleaser. We have grown past the stage of pretending to be good and they call you good name, only to lead you like a sheep before the slaughter, and then you are gone. I say this morning, I remember millions who died to set us free. Call out on the line, your name, and where are you calling from? Of course, Zoo Epileptic Network. I just hope everybody calling this morning, you have been following the program, and I request one thing for you. This is Remembrance Day. 30th of May is around the corner. And we want to remember them. Caller on the line, are you there? Caller on the line. Of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network. But then, we must continue. You have to call back if you can. Caller on the line. Caller on the line.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Good morning. Go ahead, please, if you have been following
my
me.
My name is Victor. Yes. It's, my name is Victor Chukwu. I'm calling from Aba.
Go ahead, please.
My African rep, I want to thank you people for watching.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Caller on the line. And of course, we are having some network challenges this morning, but do not make any mistake about that. Our destination is Biafra. This morning, I say, remember those men. Tell us about their action. Some of them are not here. Tell us about what they did. We don't know about some of them. Remind us their actions. Are you there, caller on the line? Of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network everywhere. Can you hear me, caller on the line?
Good morning, my darling.
Good morning. Go ahead, please. And I don't know why you are not seeing anything and you're listening to me. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
God bless you. May God bless you. May God bless Nando Kale. May God bless you, Timothy. Even if they put their time and their precious money and everything in our community to this project, God is going to be a number.
Thank you.
I'm asking for all. We must surely get Biafra. Biafra is the only hope you have. If you lose Biafra this time around, I'm telling you, in the next 20, 30 years, there will be nothing like me and you. There will be nothing like our children. That is why it is urgently important that all of us will put all our efforts to make sure that we realize this objective, which is Biafra. There's nothing we have than Biafra. If we continue to say one Nigeria, it will consume all of us. If we continue to say one Nigeria in the midst of all this, in the midst of all these failures, in the midst of all discrimination, I think we are the most miserable. The only hope and Biafra man have is Biafra. So may God bless you.
Thank you very much. We must continue. Biafra. Almost healed Biafra. Caller on the line.
Good morning, Mikel Chukwu on the line. Good morning, may God bless you. I remember our family heroes. Because at of the one that is careful that we remember them.
And of course, that line.
I'm speaking not of speech moment. I will say that I saw the government something that I paid for us.
I feel your pain, my sister, and this is some of the ways you know those who have pure Biafra in them, and I can assure you that it will not end that way. The Israelites are rejoicing today. There were times they said the capital of Israel cannot be Jerusalem. And so they pretended for a while in Tel Aviv. Today, in Hechukwude. I understand they mock us. They say Biafra will not come. Believe me, I don't think we have what it takes to make Biafra come. But what exactly does it take? Courage, determination, confronting the evil, doing everything necessary. And I tell you, Biafra will come. They will stand and watch us. And Biafra will come. As men and women said, Jerusalem cannot be the capital of Israel, even when God has ordained it from time immemorial. They witness its rebirth. So they will witness the rebirth of Biafra. This morning I say, remind us about some of their acts, sacrifice that led us here. Call on the line, can you hear me? But of course, that phone is getting mad already, but we continue. Call our WhatsApp. Are you there? Call our WhatsApp. Yes, I don't like people who pick their call and they will be looking at the phone. I don't know what they are listening to outside their device. Our people must remain focused. Our people must be ready because we want to go home. Men and women fought. The question is, why were they fighting? Can we identify what we are doing here in IPOB to what they are doing? Why did they choose to die? They knew they will die. I remember the last words of General Philip Effiong to Ojukwu. He said to Ojukwu, tell me, promise me that if you live today and I die, because Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani will kill me if you live, Ojukwu, promise me you will take my children along. Ojukwu, promise me that you will watch over them. And I think Ojukwu kept those words, because I've not heard anybody from Philip Effiong's side who has complained that Ojukwu didn't keep those promises. May I remind you that even at that, Philip Effiong himself lived and witnessed Nigerian fall. He never complained no more against the people's general, Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu. I remember. Call on the line. And of course, the phone is getting mad anyway. Too much call. Can you hear me? Call on the line. Good morning from here.
Good morning.
Go ahead, please.
We remember our leader. We remember them. I cannot believe our leader, Mazen Nandikaro, that opened up our eyes to remember our heroes that Obasanjo and Gowon they have killed. We will remember them to obey the rules. What our leader told us to do by observing the praying and the fasting. We will remember them, but all this take. We will remember them by keeping the
Now, our leader, I met by this praying and fasting. And another thing I want to say is that we have a lot because of our enemy. We supposed to be a lot because of our enemy.
Thank you very much. We have been almost hail Biafra. I need somebody to call and tell me what they did. My brother said they fought without shoe. They fought with nothing. Without shoe, without clothes. No singlet. There is nothing to fight with. With sticks. With wood. They fought. And that is coming from Samuel Emoha. Tell me what they did. Is IPOB making up this story? But who do they fight? Why do they choose to fight? And if possible, die. We want you to see it. Are you there? Caller on the line. Caller on the line, are you there?
Yes, good morning, Mazenibe.
Good morning from here. Go ahead, please.
This is Nkirukan Nabifi from Iwacha. Yes, the hour has come to remember those who died for us. The hour has come for us to appreciate them. I want to use this song to appreciate them and tell them that we are still on that. We still stand on what they stood on until Jeffrey is restored. We are here today to honor our great heroes who laid down their lives for a great nation. They died to give us hope and to give us freedom. Our gallant heroes, we held thee. Though the world denied you justice and freedom, we, your brethren, we are here today to pay homage and give our respect to you, our gallant heroes, we held thee. Nothing else can satisfy thy humble souls other than freedom of your nation. Only the freedom of Biafra can grant you rest. A gallant heroes, we hail thee. And we pray to Chukwokike Abiyama to keep you so safe in his bosom until we meet and to part no more great heroes from Biafra land we hail thee. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We must continue. Our people must understand this is the time where we will make sure we remember them. We have to remember them. If I tell you the history of George Washington, if I tell you the history of American founding father, if I tell you the history of the people who led terrorism across the world, the imperialists, these are very disgusting history, I must tell you. They sweep the bad one under the carpet and tell you that a terrorist like Frederick Lugard is Lord. Somebody's telling their story. And then Yoruba, Hausa, Fulani, inside one Nigerian will tell you that Ojukwu them, we are rebellious soldier. They call them rebellious soldier. They call them name. And then our fathers responded to them and said, don't call me rebel. Nigerian soldier, don't call me rebel. I'm a citizen, you are a foreigner. Don't call me rebel. Nigerian soldiers, don't call me rebel. I'm a citizen, you are a foreigner. They told Fulani, they told Yoruba, they told Hausa, in Biafra land, you are a foreigner. We are the citizen. How dare you call us foreigners in our own father's land? How can you say we are rebellion for protecting our land? I say somebody remember them.
not to come out and tell them, Nkan, Mazina, they cannot do this. IPOB didn't do like this. This one didn't do like this. Oh, and I got more. We are citing braveness of men for you to emulate. Somebody is telling me that hey, damn bring a deity. Are you holier than the Greeks? They use you now here, do. Tell me good thing they did. You are coming here to gossip.
Caller on the line. Your name and where are you calling from?
Hello, Master Shalom.
Shalom.
Yes, my name is Maso. I'm calling from Ahoda, Epe, precisely in Igocha, Biafra land. Hello, yes.
Go ahead, I feel your pain.
Yes, I feel your pain. Likewise, me, even where I am now in Ahoda, I am feeling very, very sad. But one thing I want to tell all Biafrans all over the world is that we should summon courage because it is coming towards that direction. Our forefathers fight to defend us. If not for the fight, we could have been alive today for us to do what we are doing. But we are doing this thing in their memory. And we pray that God will strengthen us, will see us through and make us win this battle. Because justice has been murdered and justice as well has been denied. But we, this generation of the 21st century, we are not going to stop. We are not going to give up and we are not going to stop halfway. We must fight to the end. But one thing we are showing the world is that our forefathers fight alone and they conspired against them and they are helpless. And it went that way. But this time around, instead of us to lose this battle, we are going to prove to the world that we are Biafra. We are capable of doing everything. They call us name, just like the song is Angna, they call us rebel. Whereas we are not rebel, we are fighting to defend, our forefathers who are fighting to defend their land. They call us names. But we, this generation, under the leadership of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, has came to tell the world that we are angry of what they did to us. Our death, nobody hold anybody accountable. But we have been hearing of history of First World War, Second World War, how they have been remembering them, how they have been doing that. For the death of over 5 million Biafrans, women, children, men, were massacred. Nobody hold Gowon accountable. Nobody hold Obasanjo accountable. Nobody hold the dead Buhari accountable. Nobody hold Adekunle accountable. Nobody hold all of them, all the criminals in the North and in the Yoruba. But we are here remembering our dead. We pray that Chukwuka Abiyama will give us courage, that this fight we are going to win this time around, because our forefather said that he who fights and runs lives to fight another day. Our leader has been on a way, though it's difficult. But in the day that he will land, that is the day we are going to prove to the world that we, Biafrans, we are not happy. We are angry. We are going to bring down everything down. Therefore, I am here to tell the world, Biafrans all over the world, that summon courage. Do not cry. Remain resolute. Remain determined. Remain focused towards one direction, because our direction in this case is Biafra. And Biafra is what we shall get. Thank you, because my name is Maso Ahoda, East Coordinator, calling from Ahoda in Igocha.
Thank you very much, my brother. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there? Call on WhatsApp. But of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network. Our people must understand. My brother, they wrote to me and say, men don't cry, but I'm in tears. Brother, cry have two type. One cry is a cry of submission. The other cry is a cry of terror. When some men will cry, that cry will bring about confusion in the eye of the enemy. And when you feel like crying, cry, let it touch their hearts till they are no more. Cry, let them understand that though we'll have a heart of stone, but yet our heart bleed. This is the part that makes us women. We cannot shy away from anything. In the end, we remain who we are. I say, remember them. Yoruba don't want you to remember them. They can write intellectually about Igbo man. That is your business, Wolokomi. It's to keep you more slave and more stupid. They never write good. They never remember their action. In Yoruba intellectual and radio, do they not know
They killed people. Why are they not saying it? Yes, we are sorry. There were conflict in Nigeria. And no, they are going to buy Pami and set themselves before the national television and talk down on the memory of our ancestors, calling them rebel. Most of you don't know. I say, you tell me what they said. Well, let's talk about our fathers. Don't call me rebel. Nigerian soldier, don't call me rebel. I'm a citizen. You are a foreigner. Call on WhatsApp. Are you there?
Yes, Master George Onyibe, my reverend.
Good morning.
Good afternoon, sir. Yeah, I remember that our forefathers, they are volunteer. Nobody paid them 1 cent. I remember by then that we were paying Zulu soldier $100 every month. They were paying them. And they have more than 6,000 soldiers. And we don't have up to that amount of soldier. I remember they don't have food to eat. They throw me with that corn meal. I eat that corn meal. I remember. I remember that these people don't have any uniform to wear. I remember all those things. I remember they killed a pregnant woman, operate her belly, commode the innocent child, put the child on stick, open the belly of that woman. The world did not see it. Nobody see it. They are still doing it up to today. Nobody wants to talk about it. People are sleeping. And the Yorubas are supporting everything. The 10-year-old child that wear camouflage, I keep on talking about that. I don't keep on talking about him. The white man were asking him, what are you doing? Saying he's here to defend Biafra. If our child, if our child, go on child, all of their child are 10 years, to defend war of how will you feel in your mind? How will you feel? Those that are fighting IPOP, how will you feel? Your own son, your son will stand up at the age of 10 years, wear camouflage to fight. How will you feel? You above 30 cannot come out and march shoulder to shoulder with IPOB. Imagine that boy of 10 years in boys' company. Oh, that is what I remember.
Thank you very much.
I remember, and I will never forget.
Boys' company. He remember boys' company. And then there is my brother on Facebook. He said his name is Bright Ugo. Bright say, you people are making noise. You people don't know who is looking for freedom, much for war. Ugo Bright, let me tell you, you are right. We are making noise. John the Baptist make noise to reveal Jesus Christ. You are right. We are making noise. Adam, Noah made noise to save his generation. You are right. We are making noise. Lot made noise to save the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. You are right. We are making noise. I can assure you that Christians were making noise and still making noise, asking everybody to repent. You are right. We will make this noise. And after making noise, what happened, Bright? You can't remember your fathers who were murdered. You are saying you are making noise. You are Yoruba. You are Yoruba blood. Or Hausa Fulani blood. Our issues plague you. You are supposed to be sleeping or watching nude film inside the social media platform. Why are you here? Shameless. You say you study civil engineer. But when I check you now, you are a keke na pepe driver. Yoruba blood worrying you. I ask you this morning, focus on who they are, what they do, and tell me you remember them. I choose to respond to all of you on my Facebook this morning because they are making my number to go ziggy-zagga. And then we will respond to you. Those of you on Facebook, tell me something about them. Be rest assured, I will respond to you. Are you still there, caller, on WhatsApp?
Yeah, I got from Kembo, Nabiafa land. Good morning, kisses from Warsaw, Poland. I remember, okay, following us. You
are here
from
Omaka.
Omaka, still the man saying, no, our province of Biafra land and every other protocol is observed because in a few hours now, Onyendo will be online. We appreciate him and we have to hear from him. Mazi, we are in money mood like never before, because each 30th of every year reminds us something since Onyendo initiated this program, which is highest.
This is one of the greatest yeah. recorded known achievement we have achieved so far in IPOB, that we remember them exactly. and said their sacrifice cannot be in vain, because it was their action on those very day that define who we are today. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, man, the world will know us the day Onyendo will command. He said that thing is in Sokoto. But we will see it. They kill us, but whatever they have done to us, we are undoing. Onyendo is doing, and the leadership of IPOB, they are undoing it, Mazi. Why can't we remember Dimojuku, Achuzie? Mazi, do you know the name of Achuzie? Achuzie is the Hannibal of Biafra, who killed me when they kill us two. They killed them 10. He killed them hundreds in River Niger. You don't know what he was doing there. We must remember him. We remember F. Young and all of them, the Bruce Merrog, and we remember Chimwobi, which you witnessed in your time. Mas, we are the connected people. We are people being killed who came up again. We are not happy, and we are going to retaliate them. It, the time is now. There's no better time to retaliate than now, except they let us go. Even if they let us go, our time went on in years to come. Our boys, our women, our new generation will retaliate them. Look at the small boy yesterday, calling Marcelo, 16 years in America. Asking myself, where do I go and register? They think they don't know what we are. Radicals, we are fanaticals, we are men of valor. We must radicalize all this, our generation, to know what happened, because they removed the history in the school. They were teaching us Mali Empire, Ashanti Empire. That's what they taught us.
Samuel Utoli and the Madikan Empire, Fulani and Thank the Jihadis you. Empire, and the Ara, and they killed then, millions then, and swept it under the carpet. Let them come and tell us history now.
Obasan just welded it. Obasanjo is still alive. This idiot here, France, is still alive. He takes his wife. Makachina Kenny don't need to give us full command. He's here. We enter France and we deal with that idiot. And I'm telling Biafra, hardcore fanaticals in Biafra, in Paris, any day you call, you go across and see that idiot, commit that crime and take 5 years, it's nothing. When Biafra come, you'll be released. It doesn't show time up to now. And they're still killing us. Mas, we are not happy. We are only praying that you come back. And finally, we recognize our beloved brother, Colonel Samuel Anyadefo, who is yet to be buried. He's one of our heroes. He's one of the engineers. Okay, crew, I will make us to remember all of them at any point in time. Financial Biafra, do the needful. Thank you, Mazi. We are not happy. Thank you, sir.
Moment of sober reflection. Of course, our fasting is starting this morning. Can you hear me call on the line? Go ahead, please, my brother. Tell me what you remember about them.
Just Biafra all over the world. Just take National High School. Let's not forget about that 1967 to 1970. Because if not those ones that survived, including my father and my in-law, I wouldn't live to their house. When it's because I don't say we should go into the world and the butterfly, the plenty have dominion over everything he has created, and be recreated from what he has created. Human resources is very important. They can't downsize our population. Instead, if they come in millions, we give out billions. We must restore Biafra. This concept of man is the restoration of Biafra. God make it on the world.
I want us to remember those who died this morning. Tell me about them. Every other thing, no need. And I hope you are getting ready for your fasting and praying. Go ahead.
It is because of what they did and why our ancestors defended us for us to live today. That is why we are fighting for better. Because the only son of my mother family died. He didn't come back to war. I know how that family is today. So because they died for us to live and we will live for our own people to live. Honorable Lati Biafra, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm going to say,
thank you very much. All more his Biafra, our fasting and praying start this morning. Make sure you are spiritually intact. Are you there, caller on WhatsApp?
Yeah, Master, good morning.
Good morning. Go ahead, please.
Yes, I remain Master Okachu.
Of course, that is Zoo Epileptic Network. They are good in collecting our data, but they will never allow you to enjoy Mase, what you're paying for. Go
I
ahead, please.
A true son of the soil, a true son whose Biafran blood runs in his veins, can never stand to criticize Biafran. Mazi, these our heroes and heroines who failed. They tried to give us a better country. A place we can call our own, a place we can be comfortable to live in, a place we can dwell in. Even the
I don't know what is really going on from your side, caller on the line. Your name and where are you calling from? Caller on the line.
Good morning, Mazionide.
Good morning from here. Go
thank
ahead.
Thank you so much. Why won't we remember our heroes? Lilian Mawon for calling from Aba. Every one of the lines in the zoo anthem says, the labor of our heroes can never be in vain. So why must the labor of different heroes be in vain? We have a lot of things in our hearts. Our heroes had to fight without food, without water, without clothes. They fought in pain. I still remember how my father told me what happened when I was a little bit younger. Even now, there is a scar on my leg as a result of Pashoko. One of my uncles said, instead of I would start to rule, that he would die. And the day it was declared that the war was over, he died. Why won't we remember them? Those are four.
They sang a song to remind us about what you have said. Come and the Awosa Gachani, Kainwani Ruagau, Kainwani Ruagau. They were willing to die instead of Awosa Fulani to rule them. Let them die in the war front. An idiot is coming to tell me, I'm Igbo. Let's support Yoruba presidency. I'm Niger Delta. Let's support Fulani presidency. Our real father preferred to die in war front than to be ruled by Ochenama. Don't you get it? Go ahead,
and
please.
And they did. They stood their ground. Biafra is a different project. It cannot be abandoned. Biafra is a different project. It cannot be abandoned. They contract to the Lord. He will never abandon us until he finishes wonders in our lives. The world has to see that Biafra is a divine project. And the Lord will bring it to pass. Mazionide, may it be well with you. May God bless all those that are working with you to make sure Biafra comes. So all Biafrans all over the world, please be encouraged. Home is near. Thank you so much. God bless you. Mazionide, Bogadregem, Madirezino Logemma. This Mazima. Onye hụrụ na anyị kwesịrị inwere onwe anyị, ka Chineke gọzie niile n'aha Jizọs. Amen.
Thank you very much. The truth cannot be overemphasized. We must understand. We know how all of you sound. When we are talking to Biafrans, we know how they sound. When we are talking to the enemy of Biafran, we know how they sound. When we see blood of Miss Blood inside Biafra, we know how to sound. This morning, I have only called upon you. Let us remember them. Let us remember them.
I say, wait upon the Lord.
Announcement, announcement, announcement. The leader of indigenous people of Biafra, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, declares 3 days fasting and prayer for IPOB and Biafrans worldwide from Wednesday the 27th to Friday the 29th of May 2020. The duration of the fast is from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. daily. Praying with the Psalms of David, chapters 1 to 150. The theme: Arise, O Chukwu Okike Abiama, and have mercy upon Biafrans, for the time to favor and restore her, yea, the set time is now. Psalm 102, verse 13. Day 1, 27th, chapter 1 to 50. Of Psalm 8. Read Psalms chapters 1 to 10. Prayer points. 1. Pray for God's forgiveness and confess the sins of our ancestors, sins of new generation of Biafrans, like idolatry, ritualism, kidnapping, immorality, wickedness to our brethren, and so on. 2. Rededicating our lives to Chukwu Okike Abiama by acknowledging that He alone is the God we worship with our children forever. B. Read Psalms chapters 11 to 20. Prayer points. 1. Call upon God to hear our prayers and answer us according to His loving kindness. 2. Pray that God will increase our strength and grace individually and as a people. C. Read Psalms chapters 21 to 30. Prayer points. 1. Renounce and reject every God that we and our ancestors worship. 2. Pray that God will take over the land of Biafra as His dwelling place and cause His glory to manifest in our land. D. Read Psalms chapters 31 to 40. Prayer points. 1. Pray that God will remove His judgment from us, Biafrans, and take away untimely death from our land. 2. Pray that God will restore righteousness into our hearts and cause us to be mindful of His commandments. E. Read Psalms chapters 41 to 50. Pray and thank God for answering our prayers. Day 2, 28. Psalms chapters 51 to 100. A. Read Psalms chapters 51 to 60. Prayer points. Pray that God will stop the spread of coronavirus, heal the world, and restore normalcy to the world. 2. Pray that God will set up his angels round about the borders of Biafra Nation and protect our land from invasion by our enemies. B. Read Psalms chapters 61 to 70. Prayer points. 1. Pray that God will roll out all his weapons of war against all enemies who are already in our land, like Fulanis, Amajiris, Boko Harams, Meti Allah military and paramilitary. 2. Pray that God will restore all the riches he blessed us with and give us peace. C. Read Psalms chapters 71 to 80. Prayer points. 1. Pray that God will put our enemies to shame and execute judgment against Nigeria. 2. Pray that God will revive us and bring back joy to our land. D. Read Psalms chapters 81 to 90. Prayer points. 1. Pray for God's protection upon our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, our deputy leader, Mazi Chemefo, members of the directorate, all principal officers. Also, that God will give them wisdom, understanding, and favor to pilot the affairs of IPOB. 2. Pray for all IPOB members worldwide, that God will protect, bless, and energize us to remain resolute till Biafra is restored. E. Read Psalms chapters 91 to 100 and thank Chukwu Okike Abiyama for answered prayers. Day 3, 29th. Psalms chapters 101 to 150. A. Read Psalms chapters 101 to 110. Prayer points. Pray that God will bring unity amongst all Biafrans, both upland and coastal regions, and increase our love for one another. 2. Pray that God will touch the hearts of all saboteurs to change and join the struggle, but punish those who harden their hearts. B. Read Psalms chapters 111 to 120. Prayer points. 1. Arise, O Chukwu Okike Abiyama, and avenge the blood of all Biafran heroes and heroines who died from 1914 till date against Nigeria and her allied nations. 2. Pray and invoke the blood of all fallen heroes to stand before Chukwu Okike Abiyama for remembrance. C. Read Psalms chapters 121 to 130. Prayer points. 1. Pray for God to comfort, console, and provide for those who lost their loved ones and send them help from his sanctuary. 2. Pray that God will deliver and set free all IPOB family members who are still incarcerated in various detention camps. Also, that God will heal as many of them who are still with wounds. D. Read Psalms chapters 131 to 140. Prayer points. 1. O Chukwu Okike Abiyama, our Father, restore our nation Biafra this year according to the multitude of your mercies and according to your promise to us. E. Read Psalms 141 to 150. Sing songs of praises to Chukwokike Abiama, thanking him for deliverance from slavery and death forever, and for Biafra nation independence. Note that one is not limited to the prayer points listed above. They just serve as guide. Pray as the Spirit leads you. At midnight on 29th, there will be candlelight procession on behalf of our fallen heroes. Chukwokike Abiama will surely answer our prayers, and all glory returns to him forever and ever. Ise, prepared by evangelist Uzaku Mwokike, signed by Mazi Oscar Okeke, head of IPOB Religious Affairs Committee.
And of course, the fasting and praying begins this morning. I encourage you to remember them and their deed. We remember the birth of Christ. We remember the death of Christ. We remember Muhammad and so other religious leaders. We remember even the dog that died trying to save America during the war. Yes, they remember terrorist Lugard. They remember Yushin and Diama. The world remember everybody. Some unto honor and some unto shame and disgrace. They lied against this generation of Biafra, 1967 to 1970. We are here to remind the world that everything that was said about them was wrong. The enemy, of course, I mean. And then we are here to change the story. Nigerians, we are remembering our fallen heroes and heroines. We want to let all of you know that their sacrifice will never be in vain. I'll be signing off from here temporarily, and I wish the spirit of Elohim to guide you during this moment. They will know.
So Already here.